Today, I'm going to share a solution that allows you to run LTX2 perfectly, even if you have low VRAM. Since the release of LTX2, the generation quality and speed have been quite satisfying. However, everyone has been hoping to run it on lower hardware specs, and until now, there hasn't been a great solution today. I'll show you a fully viable method, and the best part, there is no significant drop in generation quality. The videos you are seeing right now are actual results from my tests. After extensive testing, I can confirm this method works perfectly. I have also built this workflow on Running Hub, so you can access it through runninghub.ai. Running Hub is a fantastic online workbench for ComfyUI. Whenever new models or extensions pop up, they update immediately to follow up. You can use the invite link in my video description to register for Running Hub and get 1,000 free credits. Plus, you get 100 free credits every day just by logging in, so you can try out your own workflows. Now, let's look at the optimized workflow. There are many optimization details here, so let's break them down one by one. First, structurally, we aren't using a two-stage sampling process. The official Comfy workflow for LTX generates a base video and then performs an upscale. That approach invisibly spikes VRAM usage. In my optimized workflow, we use a direct generation approach. We are still generating a 1280 times 720 volts IDO with 121 frames. As you can see from the results, the quality remains very high. To run this workflow perfectly, you need to pay attention to a few things, primarily model loading. We are using two types of nodes, GUF quantized models and traditional loading nodes. If you want to use these nodes, you must install an extension that many of you might already use, ComfyUGUF by City96. GUF is a very important method for model quantization, effectively reducing the model size. I need to remind you, make sure to update this extension to the latest version, or it won't be able to load these LTX2 models correctly. The UNET Loader GGGUF node you see here comes from that extension. Note that the model we are selecting is not the native LTX2 model. This model is provided by Kijai. It is a Q4 quantized version, meaning it uses 4 bits to replace the original BF16 full precision, using K-means quantization. Kijai has provided many models in his LTX2 Hugging Face repository, including both quantized and non-quantized versions. But his main contribution is turning this model into a standalone loadable format. The model we are using has two key keywords, Q4P word, representing the 4-bit K-means quantization, and distilled, meaning it's a distilled model that can achieve good results with fewer steps. Of course, you can choose different models based on your own situation. Next, we use LoadVAE to load the video encoder, which is also provided by Kijai. You can find the video and audio encoders in the VAE folder. Below that, we load the audio encoder using a node from the KJ Nodes extension. Further down, we have another GUF loader node for the encoders, specifically dual encoders. The first model is a Gemma 3 quantized model. To use this text encoder effectively, you need to load the embedding connector provided by Kijai. You can find this in the Hugging Face repo under text encoder. Note that there are two versions. We are selecting the distilled version here as well. Next is the latent generation part. I'm using image to video. So, I take an input image and first resize it. Pay attention here. You must ensure the final resolution is divisible by 32. So, even if you write 1280 times 720, the actual resolution you get might be 1280 times 704. We get the size and generate an empty latent based on it. Similarly, we generate an empty audio latent. Just make sure the frame count aligns with your video frame count. Now for a critical step, injecting the reference image into the latent. I'm still using the standard node, but I removed one specific node that was in the original ComfyUI workflow, the one that scales the long edge to 1536. I tested it extensively and found it didn't add much value. So I just removed it. We compress the image through this node and inject it into the latent as a sampling condition. Then we combine the audio and video latents to generate the final sampling latent. Below that, we have our positive and negative prompts. We use LTX conditioning to generate the conditions for the sampling part. I used a custom sampler. The model, of course, is our GAF model. Note that the seed is set to random. For the CFG guider, connect the positive and negative conditions and the main GGAF model. Set the CFG value to 1 point. Oh, since we are using a distilled model for the scheduler, I suggest using LCM. The sigma settings are identical to the original workflow, but the steps are reduced to 8. After sampling, we get a combined latent. We split it into video and audio components, decode them separately, and get our final result. How fast is it? I'm running this on a 24GB RTX 4090. Let's run it. The visual effect is very beautiful. Let's listen to the sound. You can hear some static noise. Now, let's check the time. It took 59.76 seconds. The entire runtime is very fast. Some of you asked why there's always static noise. I thought about how to fix this and found a bit of a wild workaround. You can try it out. I've tested it a lot, and I think it's effective right here. In this section, just disconnect the latent link. Don't connect anything there. Let's run it again and listen. The audio effect is much better. People ask exactly how much VRAM this workflow uses. It is hard to give a single number because it depends on what model you load. For example, I'm loading the Q4 version, but some people load Q2. There are many other creators on Hugging Face releasing GGGAF models. Just a reminder, make sure the GGGAF model includes metadata. Otherwise, it might fail to load. Also, you can adjust the resolution yourself. Decreasing resolution or changing the loaded model changes the VRAM usage. This solution is totally adjustable. For instance, if I change the resolution to 960x540 and the frame count to 81, let's run the workflow. Visually, there isn't a huge change, right? But the generation speed is definitely much faster. Note this, it only took 24 seconds. So when discussing speed, we have to consider what model you loaded, the resolution, and the video length. Let's verify the audio fix. It sounds pretty good. So I don't recommend connecting that latent node I mentioned earlier, even if there is no theoretical reason for it. Our practical tests show the results are better without it. I've done a lot of testing. Let's look at some examples. This one is a beauty in a jungle scene. Let's listen. You can very clearly hear the insects and birds. I feel the sound generation is actually even better than the original workflow. Let's look at the next example. This is a very aesthetic scene. Let's verify. Not much noise appearing here either. This one shows a quieter scene. I don't know if you can hear it, but you can hear the breathing sound. The sound effects are arguably better than the original version. This workflow shows an oriental character scene. Let's listen to the final result. Notice the sound is the sound of a Guzheng zither. It completely fits the characteristics of oriental culture. We can also hear footsteps. The overall state of the character looks very beautiful. Finally, here is a beauty holding a bunch of sunflowers with a large loaf of bread in her arms. Let's listen. The sound is quite crisp and clear, no major issues. So after all these tests, you'll find that using this workflow generates videos where, firstly, the quality hasn't dropped, and secondly, the audio doesn't have much noise. Plus, you can choose different quantization models and resolution settings to effectively control your VAM usage. I highly recommend everyone give this a try. That's all for today. Follow me to become an AI expert.